Hey there, and welcome to the next show. Among some announcements, apologies, and whatnot, we'll be having some pot smoking scenes from movies and TV, plus some music, another stoner story, and some videos and shit. Plus, in case you didn't notice, we're wearing a couple of the t-shirts that we're going to be selling on the site real soon.
I can't outjust you.
Unfortunately, I can't get everybody moving their asses as fast as I would like them to. I'm so impatient that I would have had the store 2 months ago if I could do everything myself.
You need so much back.
Yes. I can't, so the store, you know, will be coming out anytime now. But we're also planning on keeping the prices lower than most, but the quality as high as possible, because we like to be as high as possible. Now, we also want to thank everyone for supporting the Reefer-lution and 420 Pimp for bringing this to our attention. The fact that we've achieved 420 subscribers, and by now, then some. Now, what we know that not all subscribers watch all the time, but any reason to celebrate 420 is good enough for us. Also, just to let you know, we put a bunch of really cool wallpapers in the website for everyone. They're made to fit your default icon setting on the left. Check them out in the download section at bigpotatoshow.com. You can read it below just in case you're having trouble focusing. And now we're going to focus on the rest of the show.
Focus.
Okay, we just want to mention that after the hot knife tutorial, a generous viewer also suggested using a soldering iron as well for hot knives. Just make sure the tip is clean, I guess. And that applies to some certain other things as well, too. And now, for something else.
I want our stoner story.
Shirley.
Quit calling me Shirley.
Okay, this one is about doing shrooms for Laser Floyd 3D and virtual reality games. Where I got to shoot Daryl dead, and I got twisted wires for another game. So it started off with the shrooms, of course, and Laser Floyd 3D. It was pretty fucking wild to see the 3D lasers while wasted. We kept trying to grab the laser light because they look so close. And I had to ponder, of course, if some people never actually come back from that experience. But we sort of did. Anyway, after the laser show, we decided to smoke a joint in a small park on the way to the virtual reality games. Once again, smoking joints are quite useless while on shrooms, but the act of it does help to keep you calm, I think a little bit. Sitting in a small park at dusk, wasted on shrooms, when we heard a noise behind us. We didn't know what to think at first, but cops did enter our minds. But we lucked out, and it was actually just a huge fucking raccoon that was coming out for some nighttime fun. We were also sitting up against a fence with the raccoon being on the other side of it. So we had to start cracking cop jokes after it happened. Because that's what we thought it was at first. Stuff like cops, they wouldn't climb the fence, and they'd say, "Hey, you, come here." Lazy bastards. Of course, there weren't any taser guns at the time either. But anyway, after surviving the monster raccoon, we headed for the virtual reality. Because the unvirtual reality created by the shrooms just ain't enough.
You laugh, I'll teach you to laugh at something that's funny!
So we played the original game, the very original virtual reality game, first at the same time. You just walk around on platforms and shoot at each other. So about 4 minutes into it, I managed to sneak up behind Daryl using some pillars for cover. So I'm looking at the back of his head in the game, and I'm pointing my gun right at it. Then I yelled out loud, "Hey, Daryl!" Of course, that made him turn around, and then bam, I blew his head off. It was the perfect combination of reality and virtual reality. But when I took the headgear off, Daryl wasn't dead. He was just tired of being beaten. Any game. Then I tried another one where you're a robot in a death arena, plus you get rocket boots and you shoot from your eyes. But being on shrooms too, I got so into the game that when it was over, employees had to unwind me from the cords. I twisted myself up in them so much I could barely move, and I was facing the wall behind the game. And I got the high score too, of course. So if you're going to do shrooms or Sid, we totally recommend lasers in 3D and virtual reality. Just remember, tripping out is a great place to visit, but you wouldn't want to live there. Y'all come back real soon now, you hear? And that's all for that.
Well, here's another celebrity on weed.
What we've got here is failure to communicate.
Well, a Harry Potter actor was charged with growing marijuana in his home. Jamie Waylett, who plays Hogwarts bully Vincent Crabbe in the film franchise, allegedly grew 10 cannabis plants at his home. At least he's not a cannabis crab, eh? The 19-year-old actor was found in possession of cannabis after police stopped him and a friend in a vehicle they were driving. 8 bags of the substance were found on the scene. But wait a minute. If they find weed in your car, they can search your house too? I think there's something wrong with that picture. Does that mean that if you fart in public, they can look up your ass, or what? I don't really think we want them up our asses, do we?
I don't think so.
No. So we gotta fight even harder to stop that kind of crap. I guess after Jamie Waylett's bust, we know what the next movie has to be. We'll review that stoner movie if it ever comes out. Ah well, that's it for this shit.